So we move on to sum number 19 of exercise 20A of cylinders. So sum number 19. The sum of the inner and the outer chord surface area, surface of a hollow cylinder is 1056 centimeter square. Okay, so total sum, total surface area, chord surface area is 1056. And the volume of the material is 1056 centimeter cube. Find its internal and external diameter, given that the height is 21. So it is given that first one, height is equal to 21 centimeters. They are given that CSA, total CSA is 1056 centimeter square, and volume is equal to 1056 centimeter cube. So this is the surface area, and so we know by the formula over here for CSA. So CSA is equal to, it will be 2 pi capital R H plus 2 pi small r h, right? And accordingly, I'll be having over here as 1056 is equal to 2 pi h, h is 21, 2 pi h r plus r. So it's equal to 2 into 22 upon 7 into 21 r plus r. So accordingly, it is 3. So 1056. So 1056 is equals to upon, this is nothing but 66 into 2. So 132 is equals to R plus R. So 132, and this, if it is divisible, it should be almost 9s or 8s. So it is 132 into 8 is 8 to the 16. Yeah, 16. Yeah. So 24, 25, and then yeah. So it is 8s. So that's why we get R plus R is equals to 8 over here. We next see the next formula. The next formula, V is equals to pi R square minus pi R square. Okay, H, sorry, pi square R square H minus pi R square H is equals to pi H R square minus R square is equals to 22 upon 7 into 21. Into R square minus R square, that is 1056. This is 3s. So it is 1056 upon 66 is equals to R square minus R square. Accordingly, you will see that it will be 16s. So because 132 came earlier, so it is 16 directly. So 16s. So this gives you that R square minus R square is equals to 16. But I know that R square minus R square is nothing but R plus R into R minus R is equal to 16. What is R plus R? I know it is 8. So 8 into R minus R is equal to 16. So R minus R is equal to 16 upon 8. So R minus R is equal to 2. So now you have this equation. This is the first equation. This is the second equation. You solve it simultaneously, you get R plus R is equals to 8, R minus R is equals to 2. You cancel over, 2R is equals to 10, so R is equals to 5 centimeters. So capital R, 5 centimeters. So you wanted to find out the internal and external radius. So external radius, this is the external radii. And of course, 5 plus small r is equals to 8, so r is equals to 8 minus 5, so small r is equals to 3. That's the internal radii. So external radius 3, internal radius, sorry, external radius 5, internal radius 3, that is sum number 19, 5 and 3. Clear? Okay, now we move on to sum number 21. Sum number 21. The sum of the height and the radius of a solid cylinder is 35 and its total surface area is 3080. So sum of the height and the radius, it is given that R plus H is equal to 35. So that gives me as R or I'll say better, h is equals to 35 minus r. You are given that the total surface area, so TSA is equals to 3080. You need to find out the volume. The formula for TSA is 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. Okay, so that's why it is 3080 is equals to 2 pi r, r plus h. So that is, here we know that h is 35 minus r, so it is 2 pi r, r plus 35 minus r. So automatically this becomes 35, so it is 2 into 22 upon 7 into r into 35. So this is 5 r and this is 3080. So that is 3080 is equals to r, and this is upon 2 into 22 into 5. So 11 2s are 11 2s are 8s are 280, and then you can say 5 and 2 will be 10, so these answers, and 2 will be 14. So therefore r is equals to 14 centimeters. Therefore h will be equal to 35 minus 14 is equals to 21 centimeters. We need to find out the volume now. So volume is equals to pi r square h, that is 22 upon 7 into r is 14 into 14 into 21. That will give you 3s up, that is 66 into 196. So it's 196, 66, 66, 36, 654, 54, 57, and 616, 11. So it is 1176, 6, then 13, that 921. So it is 12936 centimeter cube. That is the volume of the required cylinder. That was sum number 21 as 12936 cubic centimeter. We now move on to sum number 23. Sum number 23. A cylindrical vessel of height 24 centimeters and diameter 40 centimeters full of water. So we have got over here 23rd. The height is equals to 24 centimeters and the diameter D is equals to 40 centimeters. Therefore r is equals to 20 centimeters because radius is half of the diameter. Find the exact number of cylindrical bottles each of 10 centimeters and so here we have, we'll need to change this thing to capital R, capital D, capital H and R. This is because it's a bigger thing and you're pouring it into small bottles. And small bottles are cylindrical in shape and they are given that they are of height 10 centimeter, diameter h. So they are given that height h is equals to 10 centimeters and the diameter d is equals to 8 centimeters. So therefore radius is equals to 4 centimeters. Now we know that number of bottles is equals to volume of big bottle or big cylinder, right? Big vessel, yeah, vessel upon volume of bottle. Okay, volume of vessel upon volume of bottle will be the number of bottles which can be filled up. See, when you use such kind of formula, it becomes very easy because pi wagera cancel ho jata. So here you see that number of bottles will be, here you know that is pi r square h upon pi r square h. Pi gets cancelled. Capital R was 20 into 20 into 24 upon small r being 4 into 4 into 10. So this 4 cancels over here with 6, 6 4s. This is going to cancel with 2 and this is 3. this S2, S10, and this 10 and this 10 gets cancelled. So accordingly, it will be 60 bottles will get filled over here. So N is equal to 60 bottles. So how many bottles can be filled? So the answer is going to be 60 bottles for sum number 23. We move on to sum number 25. So sum number 25. The total surface area of a hollow cylinder which is open from both sides is 3575. Okay, and area of its base ring is 357.5 and its height is 14 centimeters. Find the thickness of the cylinder. So let's start from here itself. So the first thing what they are given to me in the 25th sum is the TSA is given as of the hollow cylinder is 3575. And the next thing what they are given is area of the base ring. So area ring is equal to 357.5 centimeter square. Right? So now what we have is firstly I know with this that pi R square minus R square is equal to 357.5. Got it? So accordingly, R square minus R square will be equal to 357.5, or let us make it simple, 3575 upon 10 into pi will be 7 going up and 22 going down. You can check whether it is divisible by 11, so 33 to 2 to 27, so this is 2's, this is 3's, then 33 to 27, so again 2's and 55, like this, right? So this will be giving me as 325 into 7, so that is 7, 35, 7 to 14, 15, 16, 17. So it is 2275 upon 20. So we divide by 2, it will be 1, 1, then it will be 3, 15 was 7, and 10 will be 5. So upon 10, so it will be 113.75. That will be R square minus R square. Now from the next part over here, it is given as, so what is the total surface area? The total surface area is 2 pi r h, take the small h, plus 2 pi small r h, plus 2 pi r square minus r square. This is equal to 3575. Okay? Now this much part I know over here, so it is 2 pi h r plus 2 into 357.5 is equal to 3575. See, because this is nothing, pi r square by r square is nothing but the ring, so it is this part is ring, so it is 2 times the rings, that is 2 into 375, so 375 2 is a will be 357, will be 714, 715, so 715, so it is 2 pi h r plus r is equals to 3575 minus 715, so that will be 0, 6, then 15, so 8, 2, 2860. Is it clear? Okay. You already given the height. The height is given as 14. So here I know the height as 14. So I have 2 into 22 upon 7 into 14 into R plus R is equals to 2860. So this is 2 is a, so r plus r over here will be equal to 2860 upon 44 in, we can directly say 22 into 4. So this is 22 1s are, and then 66 3s are, so 130. And then you can further split this as 2 as 65. So that will be r plus r is equal to 32.5. Now what you want is the thickness. What is thickness? Big R minus small r is the thickness. When you take the thickness, see if this is the thickness, if I want, this is capital R and this is small r. Thickness is nothing but this part, that is R minus R. So we here know, we know that R square minus R square is equal to 113.75, which is R plus R into R minus R is equals to 113.75. So automatically R minus R, we can say that this is R plus R is only 32.5. So 32.5 into R minus R is equals to 113.75. Therefore R minus R, that is the thickness, is equals to 113.75 upon 32.5. Is it clear? So this, we just need to calculate this thing. So if we calculate this thing, we can divide it. Let's divide it. 32.5, 113.75. If you take 3s up, then it will be 15, 1, 6, 7, and 9, 97.5. So that will give me 2 over here and 13. So it was 16.25, 1625. Yeah, that will be, this will be 5. So it is 1625. So that will be giving me as 3.5. So thickness is equals to 3.5 centimeters. Understood? It is completely based on formula. You know the formula, you just put the values in the formula, get in the form of any particular variables you get, and then you are just using those variables over here. So you got R square my R square in one part, and the second part you got over here is R plus R. You know R square my R square is nothing but R plus R minus R. So use this R plus R over here. So you get R minus R is this. Now R minus R, you don't need to find out capital R and small r for the thickness. R minus R itself is the thickness, because capital R minus small r, the outer diameter minus inner diameter, gives you the thickness of that particular pipe. So that is the thickness of the resultant thing. Okay. In fact, they also framed a formula for this. Thickness equals to R minus R equal to R square minus R square upon R plus R. So this is what they have framed as the equation. So anyway, so this is sum number 25. We move on to the last sum of the exercise, that is sum number 27. So we know, move to sum number 27. To write circular cylinders having radii in the ratio 3 is to 5 and height in the ratio 2 is to 3. Find the ratio of the curved surface area and volume. So we take it as one is cylinder 1 and then cylinder 2, C1 and C2. We get R1 is given as, the radii are in the ratio 3 is to 5. So 3x and 5x, and h is equals to given as 2y and 5y. You cannot take x over here. Remember, you cannot take x again, otherwise you will make mistakes. So it will be like this. You need to find out the curved surface area. So you know that CSA1 upon CSA2 is going to be 2 pi r h upon 2 pi r1 h1 upon 2 pi r2 h2. So that is 2, 2 and pi pi gets cancelled. R1 is 3x into 2y upon 5x into 3y. XX, YY cancel, 3, 3 cancel. So it is 2 is 2, 5. Simple. You also need to find out the volumes. So we talk about the volumes. Volume 1 upon volume 2 is equal to pi R1 square H1 upon pi R2 square H2. Pi pi cancel. R1 is 3x into 3x into 5, into 2y upon R2 is 5x, 5x into 5x into 3y. So of course the xx and yy gets cancelled, 3 cancelled with this, no other cancellation, so it is 6 upon 25. So the v1 is to v2 is 6 is to 25. That's the answer for sum number 27. Let's check the answers. Yes, sum number 27, 2 is to 5 and 6 is to 25. So this was the exercise number 20A. Now exercise 20B is based on cones. So the next video will be based on cones. So this is the end of this video.